Hello, I'm going to talk to you about something very interesting today. This is quick bite number 6. So here we're going to be talking about this oft used phrase called culture eats strategy for breakfast. So what does it really mean? So what it means is, no matter how great the strategy of your company is, if your culture of the company is such that nothing really pans out quite well, then obviously your culture is going to trump over the strategy. No matter how great a strategy you've got, but you've not fixed your culture, then obviously your culture dominates the strategy. So culture can culture eats strategy, not just for breakfast, it could be for lunch as well, if you haven't fixed that quite well. So that is what is the essence of this meaning called culture eats strategy for breakfast. So, you know, Netflix has this concept that they take the brightest of the engineers. So they said, we don't want nerds working for us. We want people who gel well with our team. And so there's several rounds of interviews, whether the engineer really fits into the culture of the company. And if not, then no matter how great they are, Netflix CEO, he said that we have a very low tolerance for nerds who don't fit into the culture of our company. So culture is very important. So how you define, so culture is not about the way the organization chart is created, how, who reports to whom and so on. So culture is based on how people interact with each other, how free they are. What is the kind of psychological safety that people really have when they interact with each other? And psychological safety is seen as an important key tenet in digital transformation and digital native companies such as Google, Amazon and Netflix and so on. So basically, if your culture of the company is quite strong and good, then you have a far greater success of doing great jobs. So psychological safety is the emotional well-being of people within your organization on how comfortable they feel when they join your company. So, you know, that is essentially what is psychological safety. So do they share personal stories with each other? Do they feel comfortable? Do they have a buddy at work? You know, those kind of things determine how you really go on with respect to the psychological safety part. So the culture of the company is quite important because it should allow people to mingle with each other, share ideas, exchange ideas, you sense of oneness with the team. And so there are various divergent thoughts here. So there are movements such as holacracy and agenda shift. And, you know, there are companies where there are no bosses at all. So there is Zappos has this culture that they have zero hierarchy. Then there's this company called W.L. Gore and Associates in the U.S., which also doesn't have a strong hierarchy. There's no hierarchy. There's no boss culture. So there's nobody. So they said, we have management, but we don't have managers. So that is how companies are structured. So here is leaving you with this thought, which will help you, understand how important culture is within organizations and how it can really end up eating breakfast, lunch and dinner at a company, no matter how great your strategy is. So thank you very much. Do like, share and subscribe for more such videos and stay tuned. Thank you.